Hi friends, we'll start with a very interesting topic and also one of the important topics for both preliminary examination and the main examination. Interesting in the terms that there is an upper air circulation which is powerful enough to increase or decrease the speed of aeroplanes. And important because questions are generally asked on this topic from both from Indian perspective, from the Indian monsoon perspective and from the world geography perspective also. So what is this topic? This is the topic of a jet streams. Now as the name suggests, jet streams has to something to do with the stream is what a flow of a water generally what we call in a layman language, stream is a flow of water, jet is a aeroplane or a flight. So the stream of an water or the stream of an air which is similar to the stream of an water but and also similar to the flight of an aeroplane is also known is maybe something must be jet stream. Now before I go into detail why the word jet stream, what is the genesis of this jet stream, I will discuss a few things with you. See, the origin of a jet stream has to do something with the pilots. Pilots are one of the best climatologists, I feel that, because they can observe the phenomena such as cloud, thunderstorms, cyclones, anticyclones from a higher height, and because they travel through different types of moisture content, condensation, precipitation, okay, forms like clouds, mist, etc. So when the pilots, sometimes if you are going by a flight, you must be hearing the common announcement that there is a turbulence in air and you are asked to tighten your seat belts and not to use the washrooms in the flight or not to move around and asked to be seated. So what are these turbulences? Turbulence means shaking up of the flight. Why does the flight shake? Because the flight is traveling or the plane is traveling with a great speed, with a high velocity of around 700-800 kilometers of air per hour, 700-800 kilometers per hour. Now if it comes under the influence or if it is hit by bird or by the pocket of an air, means it is hit by an air parcel, because of the great height, the flight is, because of the great speed, the flight is tossed up and down. When it is hit by a pocket of an air for us downwards, when we are there, are unless the air takes the speed of a very high velocity wind, air is beneficial for us. But if the same air which on in the on the, if you are stationary, the air is normal, that is the air you can easily talk in the air, you can say that air is not beneficial. But if you are moving in a high velocity car, if you are going in a car with a very great speed and if you take the hand out, the air becomes powerful, the motion of that air becomes powerful because you yourself are going with a great speed. Same thing if you are going in a flight, though we cannot take the hand out, but if the pocket of air comes, if any disturbance in the atmosphere comes, if the clouds come, the flight is tossed up and down. So they generally say it is a bad weather. Now what causes this bad weather? How does the pocket of air comes at the height of around 14-15 kilometers from the surface of the earth? Because the flight is not travel near the surface of the earth. That means that pocket of air comes at a greater height, which is of around 14-15 kilometers from the surface of the earth. If this is the surface of the earth, the pocket of the air comes at a greater height of around 14 kilometers to 15 kilometers. I'll take here 15 kilometers, 12 kilometers, etc. That means there is some kind of a circulation of an air at a greater height. What we have studied till now in the previous lecture, that we have studied the surface winds in the form of trade winds, etc. Then we studied the anti-trades and all, which are opposite to the direction of the surface winds. They are at a greater height. Now we are going to study a third kind of special wind, which is known as jet streams. Now, very rarely there is an announcement in the flight that there is a jet stream coming, and since there will be bad weather and turbulence, so you are asked to tighten your seat belt. Generally, the announcement is that there is a bad weather. Now, why they are known as a jet stream? See, the flights which were going from USA to Japan during Second World War for bombing of Japan, you must be familiar with Hiroshima Nagasaki incident, you must be familiar with Pearl Harbor bombing incident, which when the Japan bombed Pearl Harbor in USA, the answer retaliation was Hiroshima and Nagasaki, which overall changed the dynamics of the world war and in the end changing the balance of power in the world itself. So when the flights were going from USA, where is USA located here? If we draw a world map and if we see this as an Asia, then Japan is located somewhere here and the United States of America is located here. So when the flights were going from USA to Japan for bombing of the Pearl Harbor, that is from USA, which is on the eastern side, to the Japan, which is on the western side, because Earth itself is a sphere, for bombing of the Pearl Harbor, they noticed that there was sudden drop in the velocity of the flights. Sometimes the why this drop was there, because there was resistance from the air which was moving in an opposite direction. So the flights, as I showed you in red color, were moving from east to west, while there was some kind of a wind which was moving from west to east, and the wind was so powerful that it sometimes decreased the velocity, or it decreased the velocity of a flight, and sometimes even the velocity became equal to 0 km/h, like as if the flight was stationary in the middle of an air. On other hand, when the flights were coming back from Japan to USA, they noticed that there was sudden increase in the velocity of a flight, and sometimes the jet fighter planes experienced double the original velocity, or double the velocity they were traveling, as if somebody is pushing them from behind. This is what when the flights were traveling from west towards the east. So they saw that there was increase in the velocity. This led to this discovery, that is, led to further research, and it was discovered that there is a strong upper air circulation which moves from west to east, and therefore the flights, fighter jets which were moving from USA to Japan, experienced resistance, while when they were moving after from Japan to USA, they experienced increase in the velocity of a flight. And this led to a discovery of a strong upper air circulation, and because they were discovered by the fighter pilot jets, they were known as jet streams. And the second thing is streams, because they do not move in a straight path, but they move in a meandering path, or a wave-like pattern, or snake-like pattern. That is what we call as a meandering path, and therefore they are known as streams, because the rivers also do not move in a straight-like pattern. They start meandering, and therefore they were called as a jet stream. So the discovery during Second World War of a strong upper air circulation has led to of a jet stream. And this jet stream, though climatology is a very new topic, and it is an extremely dynamic topic, because pressure, temperature, humidity, these inputs keep on varying, and our technology as such is limited, that we cannot even predict the proper amount of rainfall which is in the Indian monsoon, because everything is related. Earth works as a system over here. But till today, what is with our limited knowledge, with the limited technology, we have understood that jet streams play a very important role, especially in the Indian monsoon, because we are going to study general studies geography from, and hence you should know more from the Indian point of view, and second also in the aviation industry. So if there is a flight, if it comes under the influence of a jet stream, there is a change in the medium, and because of the change in the medium, there is a tossing up or a turbulence in the flight. If this flight continues the straight path, again it will come out, again turbulence. If it goes here, again turbulence inside the jet stream again. So turbulence will be there continuously. If the jet stream is strong enough, because jet stream move with an average velocity of 140 km/h, and sometimes the velocity becomes 400 km/h, that means the jet stream move with a great speed. So if the jet streams are moving with a great speed, and the flight is experiencing resistance, then the flight, to maintain the original speed, has to increase its power consumption. Iska matlab the fuel, the more fuel is burned if it passes through the jet stream. If it passes in the opposite direction, if it passes through the jet stream in opposite direction, that means in today's competitive cost benefit world, this becomes an problem for the modern aviation industry when their transport or expenses rise. On other hand, if the aviation industry is smart enough, if the pilot is smart enough, and if they want to travel from A towards B, from west to east, to take the benefit of a jet stream, the flight passes through the jet stream. As a result of this, to move a certain distance, the flight's energy plus the push of a jet stream, the flight sometimes reaches the destination much ahead. You must have experienced it. For example, if Mumbai-Delhi takes time of 2 hours, most of the flights, many times the flights reach there half an hour before. Why? Because if everything is so much controlled because of the clear weather, no resistance of the jet stream or use of a jet stream. So the modern aviation industry uses the jet stream to its proper benefits. That is, either it uses the direction of a jet stream to reach the place so that they will save on the fuel, or it flows high up in the troposphere to avoid the jet stream, because if the flight is flowing in the opposite direction, there will be more fuel expenses, there will be more kind of a turbulence. And to avoid this, the modern aviation or the commercial aircrafts, I am talking only of the commercial aircraft, flow near the tropopause, because the jet streams, as you remember the first lecture of climatology, all the major wind system, all the major atmospheric phenomena are present only in the lower layer of the atmosphere, that is the troposphere. And to avoid the vertical wind turbulence or the vertical wind shear or the horizontal wind shear, that means the vertical turbulence or the horizontal turbulence. See, this jet stream is moving from east, west to east in an horizontal manner, but at the same it is also meandering in a vertical manner. And to avoid this vertical and horizontal wind shear, commercial aircrafts travel in the tropopause, because jet streams are generally absent in the tropopause region. While the supersonic aircrafts, they, because of the huge sound they make, they travel in the stratosphere, especially in the ozonosphere. And nitrous oxides, which are given out by this supersonic aircraft, is one of the major reason for ozone hole formation. Coming to that later on. Now, what you have to remember, the jet streams are flow in the lower troposphere. And what I mean that the in the upper troposphere, and what I mean that the commercial aircrafts travel in the tropopause, is that why I am saying this again and again, because there has been questions have been asked on this topic, where that is the where do the commercial aircraft travel, upper troposphere, stratosphere, or lower troposphere. Obviously, if the upper troposphere is the option, upper troposphere becomes the answer. If the tropopause is the option, tropopause becomes the answer. And to know this better, you look at the 2011 preliminary examination of UPSC GS paper, where you will understand what I want to say. That is, why do the commercial aircrafts travel in the tropopause region? To avoid the vertical and horizontal wind turbulence or wind shear. So before we go to it, and before we discuss the jet stream in detail, you should know what is the definition of a jet stream. I hope you are clear why they are known as jet streams, how the modern aviation industry uses it, and what is the importance of a jet stream. Now, these jet streams are extremely powerful, because you can see how they are. They are having some kind of a depth, they are having certain width, and they are having certain length. So these are, you can say, three-dimensional wind system in the upper troposphere. And so we will first start with the definition of an jet streams. And while doing the definition, as I told you earlier, do the definition word by word, because the definition, though it is only 20 words and all, but it conveys the most important part. So what is the jet stream? How will you write we will write a strong upper air circumpolar circulation. That means the definition itself says that the jet streams are strong enough. It is in upper air means it is not at the ground surface. Circumpolar means the circumference is the entire globe or the surface of the earth. The circumpolar air circulation which generally flows from, again the word generally, west to east. Why I am using the word generally, you will understand that while doing one kind of a jet stream, which generally flows from west to east in the upper portion of troposphere. Why does it flow? Because of the difference between the two air masses, difference of temperature between the two air masses at the speed of around 140 kilometers per hour and sometimes exceeding 400 kilometers per hour are known as a jet stream. So it becomes very big and very clumsy. So we will write a proper definition and then we'll explain you the different parts here. What is then jet stream? A strong circumpolar upper air circulation. A strong circumpolar upper air circulation upper air circulation which generally flows from west to east in the upper portion of a troposphere. In upper portion of a troposphere. Upper portion of a troposphere between two air masses of different temperature is known as jet stream. Between two air masses So a strong, which kind of a circulation? Circumpolar circulation. What do you mean by circumpolar circulation? That means they move around the entire globe, generally surrounding the poles. So if this is the way jet stream will move, they will completely surround the polar regions. This will be the direction of a jet stream. So such a strong circumpolar air circulation, which generally flows from west towards the east in upper portion of a troposphere between the two air masses of different temperature, is known as jet stream. Now what you mean by different air masses is the different between the two air masses of different temperature. What do you mean by the air mass? Air mass is a large body of air having uniform characteristics. So there is one air mass having high temperature, then the other air is having low temperature. This will result into two different types of air mass, and this is the reason why I took the previous lecture of tricellular meridional circulation. We have used the three different colors here. One in the tropical region, black color, if I properly remember, I don't remember the colors now. In the middle region, that is in the mid latitude region where the westerly wind moves, we have used the red color, and in the polar regions we have used the blue color. What does this signify? This signifies three different kind of an air masses. For example, trade wind is one kind of an air mass having different kind of properties. Westerlies are different kind of an air mass. Polar easterlies are different kind of air mass. Polar easterlies extremely cold, westerlies somewhat moderate, and trade winds hot and humid. So these are the three different air masses. And as I told you in the previous lecture, that the gap through which the wind will flow, that is the transition zone through which the wind will flow, are known as a jet streams. So a strong circumpolar upper air circulation. So when you write this answer, some of the key words you should remember are a strong circumpolar upper air circulation, that means not in the lower atmosphere, flows from west to east in the upper portion of troposphere, between the two air masses of different temperature, is known as a jet stream. So this is the things you should know. Now before we start with the cause of a jet stream, we will understand the other characteristics of a jet stream. So what are the characteristics of a jet stream? What are the different characteristics of a jet stream? The first characteristics are, they are located at the height of around, located at height of around 9 kilometers to 16 kilometers near tropopause, near tropopause. Second characteristics are, these are rivers of air having velocity of around, of around 160 kilometers per hour, 160 kilometer per hour, and sometimes exceeding, kilometers per hour. See, these are all factual data. You can use it as per the needs of the answer, but you should know each and everything in detail. So they are located at what height, what is their speed, etc. The third important characteristics of a jet streams are that they measure thousands of kilometers in length they measure thousands of kilometers in length, hundreds of kilometers in width, and few kilometers of around 2 to 4 kilometers in depth. So these are the characteristics of a jet stream, that they measure hundreds of kilometers in length, thousands of kilometers in length, hundreds of kilometers in width, and few kilometers in depth. So the different characteristics of a jet streams here, and their path, is wavy and meandering. That is, they do not flow in a straight path. Such wavy and meandering path is known as Rossby waves. Because of their wavy and meandering path, they are known as Rossby waves. Now, why they are known as Rossby waves? Because this wavy and meandering path was discovered by Rossby. So, it is under, because of discovery by Rossby, they are also well known as an Rossby waves. So these are the some of the characteristics of a jet stream. They are located at certain height. What is their velocity? What is their appearance? That is how much kilometers in length, depth, and width. And what is their path? Now the next topic we are going to do is the causes of a jet stream.